It's time for a video about radio, because I recently picked up this Turk tower-powered AM-FM antenna. This was a Goodwill find. It appears to be new in box, although it has these stickers on it for some reason. It says, receive your favorite hard-to-get stations on this high-performance indoor AM-FM antenna with built-in adjustable amplifier. As it mentions here, the tower was designed to be compatible with digital FM radio, otherwise known as HD radio, also has an AM section. And I just so happen to have a radio which has that HD radio digital receiver function. This is a Sony XDR-S3HD. One of the few models they made that supports HD radio, as it says right there on the front panel. And there are many good things about this radio, but one thing I definitely do not like about it is it's permanently tethered power supply brick, which always makes it a mess to store this radio because the power cord gets tangled up and there's no way to untangle it without trying to straighten out the whole thing because you can't unplug it from the radio. But this radio does have inputs for external AM and FM antennas. Well, there's also a headphone jack on the back. And first, for a baseline, I'll be using this loop antenna, which is similar to what it came with for AM. And this FM whip antenna, I think it originally came with just a plain wire, but I'll be using this instead. It just plugs right into that F connector on the back, and it's a very convenient little antenna to have. So here we go. One of the unusual things about HD radios is that not only does this one have a built-in cooling fan, but as you saw, you also have to wait for it to boot up when you turn it on. So we're on AM right now.
Glen Shock, 1010 winds, Eastern Parkway in Crown Heights.
Winds news time, 1244.
I was diagnosed with diabetic.
High blood pressure.
High cholesterol.
Terrible acid reflux.
Are you sick and tired of being sick and tired? Wouldn't you rather be healthy, energetic, and fit? I'm Dennis Black. 10 years ago, here in Dallas, I developed a Texas-sized solution to America's health crisis.
TexasSuperfood.com.
Well, here it is, receiving an HD radio signal on AM. But as you just heard and saw, it dropped out to analog for a few seconds because the reception is not very good on this station. Barely. This is only one of two semi-local stations that are using HD radio on AM. In New York City, there's 1010 Winds and 880 WCBS. And sometimes I'm also able to pick up 1210 WPHT from Philadelphia. See, the HD light started flashing. But I don't know if it's going to be strong enough to pick up and decode the digital signal. Yeah, it's not even showing up on the signal strength meter. But it is detecting the digital carrier.
City Field. This is Giant coach Ben McAdoo. The Giants are now 1-6 after their 24-7 loss to the Seahawks on Sunday.
We have to go back and take a look at the first 7 weeks, evaluate us schematically, evaluate ourselves schematically, the personnel, coaching, everything. Take a look at it, find a way to get our body back.
Well,
it'll be big for the second half.
You heard it. It's going back and forth between analog and digital.
Only once in seven tries.
Now
the Jets and the Dolphins, as they rallied from 14 down in the final 12 minutes to win 31-28.
Let's try WCVS.
More protection.
More and more clouds are rolling in. We're still saying partly sunny, though.
See,
72 in Central Park. The high today, 74.
On the air at 880. Streaming live at TuneInRadio.com and WCBS880.com. We are WCBS News Radio 880.
Good afternoon. I'm Pat Farnak.
It's a strong signal, but it's only picking up the analog for some reason, even though it's showing the call letters.
All right.
So that's my baseline of AM reception using this little loop antenna. I've recorded an FM band scan using the Sony HD radio, but it's 12 minutes long, so it's too much to put into this video. So I've uploaded it to my other channel, and I'll include a link to it in the description if you want to watch it. So inside the box with the Turk antenna, we got the antenna itself with permanently attached wires here. We got a power supply, a matching transformer. I guess this is for radios which just have screw terminals for the FM antenna instead of the 75 ohm connector. Got a owner's manual and an accessories catalog. So I have the Turk antenna connected and powered on. It has this gain control in the front, which I have turned all the way up, though I don't think it makes a difference on AM. And so far on AM, I'm getting about the same results as I was with that standard loop antenna. WCBS shows the digital signal, but does not decode it. Just shows the call letters, but doesn't decode the digital audio.
Putting it in its carrier and tossing it into Mauritius Bay because he didn't want to pay.
1010 Winds.
Time lease offers and special
does
finance.
Decode in digital.
Winds News Time 170.
Today there are over 47 million Ford vehicles on the road, rolling on over 188 million tires.
See a participating Ford dealer for details through 12/31/17.
At Discover, we believe anniversary should be a time of celebration.
And one reason why the AM reception with this antenna is basically the same as using a standard loop antenna is because this antenna is only amplified on FM. You can see I have it unplugged right now, and my FM reception has gotten very poor. But on AM...
Season. Nets and Magic, his second quarter, 9 minutes to play in
reception
Orlando.
Is the same as it is when it's plugged in. And another thing, with having both AM and FM built into one antenna, that means the position that gives you the best FM reception may not give you the best AM reception, and vice versa. So you may have to either keep moving the antenna as you switch bands, or you may just have to find a compromise between the two bands in your reception, or you can just forget the AM antenna that's built into this and just continue using a standard loop antenna for AM, because it's not really going to be any better on AM than one of these. As for FM reception, I wrote down a list of all the signals I could get in HD with the Turk tower antenna and also with the regular whip antenna, and it turns out with the Turk tower antenna I can get 20 FM stations to decode HD radio, an additional 2 stations which illuminated the HD radio indicator but were not able to decode the digital signal. Now with a regular whip antenna I was able to get 19 stations to decode HD radio on FM, but an additional 4 stations which indicated HD but were not able to decode it. So this Turk antenna was basically like taking 2 steps forward and 1 step back. I was able to get 1 more station in HD, but in terms of the overall total of stations I could receive either in analog or HD, it was basically the same. Because a lot of the time, if you're not able to receive a FM station in HD, it's not because of inadequate signal strength, it's because of adjacent channel interference, especially in a region with a crowded band like it is here in New Jersey. And a non-directional FM antenna is really not the best choice for that kind of reception condition. And I've found that even a cheap pair of rabbit ears will do a better job of that than one of these non-directional FM amplified antennas. So if you want to improve your FM reception, instead of spending $20 on one of these Turk amplified antennas, first just try a cheap pair of rabbit ears. You can even find these in dollar stores sometimes. And experiment with different positions, different locations of the antenna, and expanding and collapsing the rods, and you may be able to improve your reception quite a bit. And as for improving your AM reception, there is one Turk antenna that works very well. It's called the Turk AM Advantage. It costs about $40 and it's well worth it. It's a tuned loop antenna similar to the more expensive Select antenna, but it can work with any AM radio. It does not need an external antenna input on the radio. It works either with a direct connection or through inductive coupling. So just by placing it on top of or near the built-in AM antenna in many portable radios, it'll improve their reception quite a bit.